Fibonacci, or how I learned to stop worrying and love the ratio. Leonardo Fibonacci. His most famous work, the Fibonacci sequence, is where the following number in the sequence is the sum of the previous two parts. So, the sequence from 0 is 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34, 55, and so on. If you divide the highest number from the previous, you get 1.618, also known as the golden ratio. This ratio plays a prominent part in what we find pleasing to the eye, playing a big part in what's considered beautiful in women, art, and architecture. With such prominence, the golden ratio of course carries value in trading technical analysis. The sequence itself isn't used in trading, but rather the derived fractions of a previous move are used to calculate support or resistance for the price movement going forward. Here's a nice example. Bitcoin in mid-July 2017. The price bottoms out at $1,800 and retraces upwards to $3,500. Notice the conformity to the Fibonacci fractions before the 100% was marked, especially 0.618, the inverse of the golden ratio. A lot of resistance there. After a brief retracement, it rises with little resistance to 1.618, our golden ratio target. This kind of extrapolation is known as a Fibonacci extension. Further, if I subdivide the extensions, there is a clear conformity to the price action even after the 1.618 golden ratio target. Now all this from a plot drawn on 2 week old data. If this isn't art, I don't know what is. These subdivisions I shown in the second image are 0.382, which is a number in the sequence divided against the number two places to the right, and 0.236, which is a number divided against the number three places to the right. As you've seen, marking these fractions in a chart has shown to give a very high probability of support or resistance in the move going forward. This gives traders an important target in assisting you in telling if a move has a solid risk to reward ratio. You've probably seen a good example of me target hunting on one of my previous videos using this kind of system, looking for Fibonacci conformity, then extrapolating atop. It ended up hitting my 5k target before it dumped all the way down to 3k. That's what I call a top snipe. If you're paying attention, you'll notice there is a number included in the grid, even though it has no real relationship to the sequence. That's 0.5, halfway, the glass is half full or half empty if you're a bear. You think I'm kidding about, but it's thought that if a move completes and retraces but stays above the 50% mark of that move, then the trend will continue. If it breaks down below 50% of the move, then it was a trap move, a fake out. This does work both ways, mind you. Say there's a big downtrend, but the bounce stops at around 0.382. Well, too bad, sunshine, we're retesting the bottom, aren't we? Thank you very much for listening, and cheers. For more frequent updates, don't forget to follow my Twitter.